Welcome to Sober.Coffee, a weekly coffee chat sharing experience, strength, and hope for anyone on the sober road to recovery. You can download Sober.Coffee weekly on all podcast platforms and check us out on Instagram at Sober.Coffee Podcast and on Twitter at Sober Coffee Pod. To learn more about us and to help support these sessions, visit online at Sober.Coffee. Here are your hosts, two guys on their own path to recovery, Mike and Glenn. Let's join them at the coffee shop.
Oh my gosh, what's going on now?
It's my yoga meditation chant.
Oh geez.
Yeah. So here I've got you know, many times in the morning I'll open up my daily morning devotions, you know, start off with some quiet time and read some, get into some meditation.
Stock tips?
No, not stock tips.
Oh, okay.
No. That's
not anymore,
later.
Huh?
Yeah, right.
Prior life.
But I got to share with our listeners that you bought me a special meditation book called Sarcastic Daily Meditations. And I'm telling you, I find these very deep and moving. So just flipping open here, levity has no spiritual value, right? That's a good one. How about this one? Anxiety will help prevent most uncomfortable things from happening to you. Right?
Dude, I love it.
And oh, words of wisdom.
So I'm on this social media site, nobody's heard of it, called Instagram, and
it's a fad.
It's just a fad. And so I, you know, I start seeing some of these things, and then I'm just like loving it, because a lot of times, you know, recovery and doing the steps, and I mean, you're digging in the dirt, right? It's serious stuff.
Sure.
And I saw this, I'm like, it doesn't all, I mean, we have so many laughs. I'm like, it doesn't all need to be serious. We can make fun of some of this stuff, and we can have, you know, a sarcastic look and have some laughs. And so I thought that would be a great little gift for you.
Yeah, it's
good, because I know you read a lot of serious meditation books.
And oh, like, yeah. Well, this is a good thing. Up. And I will put a link to it. It's hysterical. We'll put a link to it in the resource room. And by the way, check out the resource room at sober.coffee. So there's no www and there's no .com. It's just sober.coffee. And check it out. And there's a great resource room out there. All the different coffee sessions we've had, will if we mention something, we throw it out in the resource room. So check it out. It's good stuff. Glenny, what are we talking about today?
I was just laughing because I have a new shirt on.
Yeah, what does your shirt say?
Sober AF.
Oh, you're a friend of sober?
That's probably what it means. Sober, a friend.
Yeah, right.
I don't know, man. I don't know if it means alcohol-free or sober as fuck. I don't know.
I don't know. One of the two.
Hey, we're having fun. All right. So for folks out there, first of all, thank you for reaching out. We get a lot of people that reach out and just say hi. And, you know, it's always great. We got a in fact, we got a nice voice message the other day, and we're actually going to have her on and tell her story. But it was just really sweet. So our different ways to connect with us are so Instagram is sober.coffee podcast. And we try to get on there 3 or 4 times a week, drop stuff on there. On Twitter, we're sober.coffee pod, P-O-D. Our email is podcast@sober.coffee. That's the way to email us. We get some good emails. And then if you want something else on Twitter, there's a guy out there on Twitter that's focused on sobriety, and he is at Stay Sober Today.
Good stuff?
No.
No?
No, it's me.
Oh! That's so hysterical.
Yeah, it's not, you know, so usually it's pretty weak stuff, but, you know, we share some show stuff on there, and I think I got 4 followers.
I love it. Well,
yeah, but that's
25% of the listener base.
That's 100% increase from the week before.
Yeah, right. All right, excellent.
All right, so what are we talking about today?
Yeah, so meditation. I started out with my hummada, because
I was wondering what you're doing.
Yeah, you know, because I thought the whole meditation thing was
the engine going.
Yeah, it was a little wacky at the beginning because, you know, it called me to be quiet, and I don't know how to be quiet, as you could tell on this coffee sessions. I get a little caffeine in me, and there's no, you know, quieting my brain down. So help guide me into why meditation is important in our road to recovery and just living a better life. And then let's talk about some practical steps on how you can get started or or enhance your meditation experience?
So probably the best way to do it is start at the beginning, mm-hmm. right? So when I first heard of meditation, I mean, maybe just throughout my life, right? I mean, I heard people that meditate, and the visual mm-hmm. that I have in my head, and I realize some people do define it this way, but my visual was, you know, a man or woman sitting with their legs crossed, sitting with their fingers together.
Hamada, hamada, hamada.
Yeah, the hamada, hamada, hamada.
Mm-hmm.
That's how I, you know, and then, you know, I've heard of transcendental meditation. I'm not really sure what that is, but I've certainly heard of it, right? So
I think I took some of that in the 70s.
Did you really?
Transcendental.
Did you do some shrooms before you did that or what? But so, you know, I didn't really know what it was or what it is. You know, so I kind of thought initially maybe that's some weird stuff, right? And it, most times in my life when I don't know about something, I think it's weird,
mm-hmm.
right?
Oh,
so,
yeah.
So that's kind of how I looked at it.
Okay.
And so through my recovery process, I have, you know, learned different definitions of meditation. And then I've got one for myself that I've kind of built into.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but probably the first thing is... probably a good way to put it, and I think this was on one of your bullet point lists, is meditation is the art of listening. Mm-hmm. And I think that's really relevant. That's kind of where it is for me at my stage today. But if you Google, you know, Dr. Google, what meditation is, it talks about the practice in which an individual uses a technique or process to focus the mind and achieve a clear, calm mental state. So I can align with that.
Right.
You know? So, you know, again, I'm not sure. I mean, for some people, I don't think we need to put a name on it like, you know, TM, right? Transcendental meditation. But just to kind of unpack this, right? Probably the first situation that I remember where I, you know, for me, meditation is spending time alone in your head.
Mm-hmm.
And that's probably how I look at it, right? And the first time I did that, I remember I was in my 4-month program and my counselor gave me an assignment. He gave me a white chair, plastic white patio chair, told me to sit outside, no electronics, no input, nothing. Just sit outside for 3 hours.
What?
And just be with myself. And it was probably one of the most challenging times of my life.
Yeah, painful.
Oh, my gosh. Spending time with Glenn was very painful.
Okay, so help me out here because I'm not – I'm in meditation 101, okay, really, and I've just entered the
really?
Class. Yeah.
You're at least 102, but
no, 101 for sure. You know, I get in the program in a lot of the readings, they talk about prayer and meditation and I check it off. Yep. Prayer. I'm really good at prayer. I'm good at laying out my needs, wants, desires, praise, thanksgiving. I'm gratitude. I'm all about all that. Right. But then it's the listening part. It's the quieting myself down that I have found to be quite challenging. So do me a favor talk to those that are walking into 101, because first of all, tell me why it's so important. And tell me, secondly, what voice are you listening to? Is it just a revised version of Mike's voice, or am I trying to get to another voice tell me what my end game is that I know I've succeeded or failed at meditation?
So I don't think there's a meter.
Okay.
Right? I don't think there's a gauge that sit there and say, you know, in fact, you know, I jotted down some tips that have helped me kind of be successful in meditation. And right. That's one of them.
Okay.
Don't judge.
Okay.
Don't judge your meditation time as being, wow, that was really good. Or that hit the bullseye. Or, you know, boy, that was a terrible meditation time. Right. You know, it's almost like sex. You can't have bad sex, right?
Oh, mercy, he went there.
I'm sorry. But, you know, it's almost like you can't have bad meditation. If you do it, you're going to get something out of it.
Okay.
And so that's one of the things is don't judge.
Love it.
But so thinking back to that white that white chair is I spent 3 hours inside of my head, and there was such chaos, and there was so much stress and uncertainty going on. I mean, it was terrible.
Here's my question.
That was day one.
Yeah, at the beginning, of the 3 hours, it had to be like high, you know, trains, just what do they call that? The crash derby, you know, where cars are just going 85 different directions. At the end of the 3 hours, where was your brain? Was it still chaotic?
Yeah, no, it was still chaotic. It was what the fuck am I doing here? What have I done? Why am I doing this? This is dumb. I mean, it was noise.
Okay.
It was head trash for 3 solid hours. Nothing was processed. You know, I came out of there really saying, man, I am fucked up.
Okay.
Just because I hated myself. I had so much shame, remorse. I'm in yet another recovery program, another rehab program. You know, I hit my bottom. This is 2014. So, I mean, it was one of the most painful things, mentally painful things I've ever been through in my life.
Well, take me
and
to
there was no relief.
And take me to where you're at now, and then we're going to go into the middle. Where are you at now when you take
I will tell you exactly where I'm at right now. That's a great question. Yeah. Because I think, and I haven't done it, and I probably should, I think I could take that same white plastic chair and sit outside for 3 hours and be in total nirvana. I think I would embrace it. I think I would enjoy it. I think I would value it. I would get stuff out of it. I would use a lot of it to talk to my higher power. Mm-hmm. I would use a lot of it to reinforce a lot of the great stuff that I'm doing, just some good positive self-talk, you know?
Okay, that's a what if. Tell me what happened, because I know you meditate in the mornings.
Yeah.
So tell me what happened, maybe not this morning, yesterday morning. Give me a recent example of your, was it 15 minutes, 30 minutes? And what was the experience?
So again, this is Glenn's experience. This is what Glenn
does.
That's
what I'm looking for.
It may not be the Google definition of meditation.
Okay. I'm okay with it.
When I get up in the morning, I get up early, 4:30 or 5, right? First thing I do is I go down and make myself a cup of coffee. The next thing I do is I've got my Bose noise-canceling headphones that I love.
Mm-hmm.
And I go, nobody else is up in my house except for my dog. So when I'm getting my coffee, I let my dog out and I feed my dog, and he's a golden retriever. Love the crap. He's my sober buddy. Mm-hmm. He's never drank a day in his life. So he sits next to me and I sit in my leather chair that I love. It's comfortable. And I open the blind so I can start to see the sun comes up whenever it starts to come up. And I listen to music. So I use
AC/DC?
Music. What's that?
AC/DC?
No. I usually listen to quiet music, very quiet piano, but it's very soft and it's very quiet.
Mm-hmm.
And I start out with my morning prayer, right? And it's, you know, hey, God, you know, sometimes I call him dude because we have a good relationship today. And I'm not saying that to be disrespectful. It's just the level of relationship I have with them. I'm like, dude, you know, hey, really grateful for what I've got going on here. You know, really grateful for the opportunity to wake up, and because there were many mornings I almost didn't wake up. And, you know, hey, I have a day ahead. And so, you know, I kind of go to page 86 in the big book, right, of what to do when planning your day. But it's almost like, you know, hey, I'm going to have challenges today. I need help. You know, come along with me. Let's do this together. I can't do this alone. Let's do it together. And I list things that I'm grateful for. And, you know, so I'll put it out there. And then.
So you're praying.
So I'm praying. And then I also, you know, do a reading, you know, that's spiritual, you know, and that kind of feeds things too. And then I'm just quiet for 10 minutes. I'll shut my eyes.
You're just quiet.
I'm just quiet. And I'll shut my eyes and I'll just, you know, I'll just let things work. You know, I'll just let things cook. You know, it's all positive.
So no music, no guided.
No, I do listen to it. No, I do listen to music.
You're still at that 10 minutes. You still got this little music going in the background.
I still have little music going in the background. It's not guided meditation or anything like that.
Right.
There's no speaking.
Right.
And I'm just quiet for 10 minutes, and it gives me a chance to listen. And one of the things I learned about prayer, you know, I pray differently today than I did before. And, you know, you can't say a 5-minute prayer then go off on your day. You got to have time to listen back. Right. So that 10 minutes or so is kind of my time to listen back. And then, you know, I get up and I, you know, after that's done, you know, I get up and I start. First thing I do is I make my family's lunches. You know, so I go in the kitchen, still have my headphones on, and I turn the lights on, which I hate to do, and, you know, I start making my family lunches. And when I do that, mm-hmm. I listen to spiritual motivation stuff mm-hmm. or just regular motivation stuff, you know, really get me charged up.
Okay. So
get the engines going.
I thank you so much for sharing that, because I'm just looking for practicality. I'm looking for what really is you're experiencing, because – you know, in the program, they say in how it works, you know, if you want what we have and are willing to go to any length to get it, you know, and the sentence should end, then do what we do, for Pete's sake, right? So I want the level of serenity. I don't know how to meditate, but you just framed out a good starter pack, you know, and I'm going to venture to guess that in your 10 minutes where you're quiet, you know, you might find direction in something you're struggling with. You might find nothing, but at least you've listened for 10 minutes. So there's no, like you said, don't judge. There's no real thing that is going to, if you do it this way, this result is going to happen. You just have to be open to that 10 minutes of being quiet. And at the very least, it's you're starting your day on, and this is what I heard you say, your feet are firmly on the floor. You're grounded. So often for me, I get up, I make a cup of coffee, and I'm starting to think about my day. I'm looking at my Google Calendar. I'm looking at my email, and it just throws my balance off, you know? And what do I listen to you? I want that. I want that serenity. I want that foundation in my day.
Yeah, there's some common themes that come out, you know, and hey, there's times thoughts come into my head, you know, that kind of creep over my quiet time.
Sure.
Right. I might have a big meeting coming up that day or whatever, but it's almost like I'm in a movie theater and I'm like, I don't have to engage in that thought next. You know, it's almost like how you swipe on Tinder.
Right.
I'm joking about that, right. But you know, it's almost like, no, I'm not going to engage that thought right now. And I just swipe it out.
Okay.
You know, it's almost like I'm sitting in the theater swiping, you know, mm-hmm. I'm not going to engage with that. So here's some tips, you know, that have helped me and I know I've helped you. One is find a quiet place, mm-hmm. right? You know, it's hard to do meditation when you're in the middle of chaos and, sure. and you're in the middle of stuff.
Right.
I do it the same time every day. I have a routine, right? And that's kind of how I get started. I get comfortable. You know, I have a cool chair I get comfortable in. I got my coffee there. You know, it's kind of a spiritual routine for me. I do it early. You know, before anybody else is up and about. It's hard to do when there's chaos rolling right. in the house.
Mm-hmm.
I do like to become aware of my breathing. Mm-hmm. I'm not one of those breathing mantra, you know, folks that do all the breathing stuff. I actually hate that, so I don't do it. But I'm aware. I'm just aware of my being.
And to be clear, what that's doing, it's taking the focus away from letting your mind go wherever it wants to go, and you're focusing on in-breath, out-breath, in-breath, out-breath.
Right, because that's a very neutral
okay.
thing to focus
right.
on.
Okay.
Right? I'm very aware of my thoughts, and just like I said, I don't have to participate in them.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Just swipe them, right? I do, you know, I do use that time for prayer. And I do, you know, make sure I'm not trying to judge. I'm not trying to score my session. It just is.
It just is.
You know, and I really coach myself not to, you know, rate, oh, that was a really good meditation. You know what? Who cares? It just is. I just do it, right?
Right.
Some common themes that I get out of it, right, is, you know, what I hear back is probably a good way to put it. All is good. I am good. I am not alone. We're going to win. We're going to be okay. It really helps centers me. It kind of fuels my peace. But, it, you know, it's also a time for hearing God.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a couple times, a couple instances where I clearly hear God. One is in my quiet time in meditation. Another is I hear God in the rooms of AA.
Right.
God speaks, for me, God speaks through other people in the room of AA. God gets his message of what I need to hear through other people and their shares in the room of AA.
Right. And some people.
How about you?
Yeah, no, absolutely. I'm enthralled with this morning's topic because it's so important to me to get to a level. And what the beauty is you just told me, don't aspire to get to a level. Just aspire to be.
Well, what is a
just
level?
Right. Well, that's
you
the thing.
You can't measure it.
But that's
right?
where I was off base right. because I was expecting if I do ABC, I'm going to get to D. And you're telling me just do ABC and let it go. Let it be. Just, as you said, it just is. And that really reset this whole thing for me. But I totally agree with you that the answers to my life, and there's a lady in the program I absolutely, and I love, there, so many ladies have done so much to my road to recovery, but she says the universe will unfold as it should, right? And she says it with such grace and peace and dignity that the world shall unfold as it should. The world will unfold as it should. And that is what I just heard you say. You if you go into a situation, if you're listening for direction from your higher power, if you're listening for it, you can hear it. If I go into a meeting and I'm just worried about what I'm going to say and trying mm-hmm. to get stuff off mm-hmm. my own shoulders, well, then I've really taken the short stick in the opportunity that I had to just sit and listen. Because I prayed, I asked the question, give me guidance in this direction. All right, well, where's the answer going to come from? And if it's not going to be a voice in my head, it's going to be something I hear, see, or experience.
Love it. You know, when we talk about meditation, there's a tool that I learned when I was in my final 8-day detox. In 2014, I mean, I can't even tell you the pain that my head was in. And so, you know, you have to go to these groups when you're in detox. So I went to the afternoon group and this woman came in. She's doing guided meditation.
Mm-hmm.
And I had never heard of that before. And I'm like, oh, here we go.
Mm-hmm.
This wacko stuff. So I sit down. I mean, I can barely function. I'm sitting down. I'm in this hospital gown. And for 30 minutes,
mm-hmm.
I was in such peaceful nirvana.
Mm-hmm.
I was outside of my head and I was on some beach.
Mm-hmm.
And the way she walked us through the story of guided meditation, I was visualizing some beach. I was there
mm-hmm.
on some beach enjoying the beautiful waves and the sunshine. I mean, I was out of the hell of my head mm-hmm. and I was on some beach somewhere
nice.
For 30 minutes. At the end of 30 minutes, she turned the lights on and I was right back in my hell. But I use guided meditation today.
Okay.
And I for me, that was a good place for me to start.
Right.
Because
okay.
I didn't know where to start. Right.
Sure. That's fantastic.
I didn't want the white chair episode again. So I started with guided meditation.
And there was a beach. So there was something you did. We mentioned on another session. Do you recall what there's one guided meditation you touted? It's in the resource room. So.
Yeah. So her name is, and all you have to do is go on YouTube and search guided right. meditation.
Right. right?
I still use it today and I use it today when I wake up at 1 o'clock in the morning and
okay.
my brain turns on and I can't okay. turn it off and I can't sleep, but I have to sleep. And you know, that whole gymnastics
okay.
starts turning
sure.
on. And you know, that used to be a real trouble part for me. I used to drink at that time cause I couldn't deal with my thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
I couldn't be alone with my thoughts.
Mm-hmm.
Today I can, but you know, still my brain starts clicking on. And so I use guided meditation. And so I go on
okay.
YouTube and I Googled or I searched, Michelle Sanctuary.
Right.
And she's probably got 100 of them, but the first one that I did, it was amazing. And I still go to that. It's called Cabin in the Woods.
Okay.
And I'm telling you, I don't care what's going on with your life. You put, you know, some noise canceling headphones on, and you put that on and you're walking through the woods in a snowstorm to a cabin. And then you got fireplace, and I mean, you hear
right.
everything. And I mean, it just gets me out of my head
mm-hmm.
and into a better place,
right.
you know? And so there's a ton of those.
Good. Well, we'll have that link in yeah. the resource room as well as others. And Glenn, if I could, I'm going to promise this now. we'll just have a little one page. Get started with meditation, just a one pager on what you need to do to get started, kind of framing out what Glenn talked about this morning, finding that quiet place, sitting in a comfortable chair, getting yourself situated, and do this for 10 minutes just to get people, give people like me a jumping off point.
Yeah, for me, the starting point, it was, I mean, those things are really cool, but for me, making the commitment.
Making the commitment.
And just saying, you know what, you know, and we're focused on, you know, with a couple of different groups I'm in, just doing like a next half step, right? Let's just take another half step forward doing something. And so if you're not doing it, just find 10 minutes, right? 10 minutes, first thing in the morning, you know, get a beverage, you know, non-alcoholic preferably. Just get a beverage and go somewhere quiet and just spend 10 minutes. And even if you don't have a relationship with any higher power, right, just sit there and say, hey, I'm thankful that I can sit here right now for 10 minutes of peace and quiet. I'm thankful for what's around me. I'm thankful I have an opportunity today. I'm thankful I can get up to bat. I'm thankful for the relationships that I have, you know. And I mean, I also say, hey, just give me strength today. Just give me strength to have a good day. Give me courage to talk to people and to serve and to treat people the right way. And man, I'll tell you what, it's hard to really measure on a day to day, but over time that has had such a positive impact. In fact, I'll start wrapping up with this. You know, I'm in business, you're in business, right? And there's a big book by this dude, Tim Ferriss, called Tools of Titans, mm-hmm. right? So it talks about all the big industry, you know, leaders, right? The CEOs or founders or whatever. And you know what the common theme was for like 95% of these people?
Mm.
They start their day with a quiet time of meditation.
Mm.
And that is just a really, you know, and I read that before I started doing meditation. I'm like, well, there's got to be something to that. Mm-hmm. So that helped me surrender and just start doing it. And, you know, I can say without a shadow of a doubt, it has a very positive impact. I probably can't point to exactly where, but it just helps center me and helps get me ready for the day and be grateful for where I'm at.
Glenn, this coffee has been great. I'm telling you, I feel more relaxed just knowing there's a relaxing tool out there.
Well, that's because you did all those hummina, hummina, hummina.
And some, I feel like switching to decaf. Not.
That's awesome, brother. Always great to connect.
All right, thanks, man. This is a good one.
I look forward to next time.
All right, talk to you. All right, bye.
Thanks for joining us for today's coffee chat. To contact the show, email us at podcast@sober.coffee. If you need immediate help, the AA hotline is 800-839-1686. The National Suicide Prevention Hotline is 800-273-8255. Remember, Mike and Glenn are sharing their own journey on the path to recovery. Any suggestions, medical or otherwise, are their own experiences and should not be viewed as professional advice. See you next week, and remember, there is a solution.